Hello and welcome back to Seaside Garage. So it's been a couple of days with the Škoda after the carb rebuild, and it is very improved in my opinion. It starts a bit easier, still not perfect though, and it runs a lot better. It pulls a lot harder, especially when giving it full throttle where both butterflies open, so that was a huge success. But today I'm gonna fix something else, because there is stuff in the interior that is not really working. And I'm gonna start with the most annoying thing and fix that today, I hope. Because if I put the car in ignition, there is absolutely no response on the fuel gauge. And that is annoying because, I don't know how much fuel goes in the tank and I cannot reset anything, so I'll have to remember the mileage, and then I have actually only dared to go around 200 kilometers between each fill up just to be sure that I'm not running out of fuel. So I'm gonna fix that today, I hope. Also, I was trying to adjust the heat a while back and I snapped the cable. That is annoying. The hose down here, the valve down here, is working fine. It's just the cable that snapped. So I'm gonna change the cable today and fix the fuel gauge today, I hope. So let's get to work. So the fuel gauge lies behind. The seats. Well, not really here. But most likely under here. Right underneath this hatch. But before doing anything else, I'm gonna disconnect the battery just as a safety thing, because there is wires and there is fuel. And those things should be combined very carefully. Here we have the battery. Some say it's hard to find on a Škoda, but not if you know where to look, because each and every time I have been trying to find the battery, it has been located right here. Yes. And once again, take a look at my wonderful Škoda. There is still this protection plastic underneath here. That is so impressive. But underneath this little hatch, lies the fuel gauge. This car does not have a fuel pump in the tank. It's the mechanical one on the engine that we took apart in the previous video. So down here is only the gauge. Here we go. Next step is to take a look at the wires and remember how they go on, and then take them off actually. One. Then I should be able to just unscrew these. So I wonder if I'm even able to take this out. Maybe this one first. It almost feels like it's not possible to take out with the thingy attached, but I could take it off and then I think I should be able to get it out. Like that. And then this like this. Whoop! And here we have it on the bench. It was actually stuck to begin with, but I got it to move. But it won't work freely. I think I should be able to take it apart and try to clean it up, but this one was actually pretty cheap. So when I had to order some other parts that I'm gonna fit on later, blower engine, washer pump, I'm just gonna put this in. And then it should work, I hope. Let's try. Oh, and this is also color-coded. How nice. And then we can just put this back in. And yes, I know this is the easy way to fix it because I don't fix, I just change, but I am looking so much forward to having a fuel gauge that actually works, so yeah. It's the easy, but not the cheapest way to do it. But it should work. And to be honest, I'm not sure that I could fix the other one because it was extremely stuck, so I expect a lot of damage to have been done already. And then I'm just gonna tighten it all up. I could have bought a new gasket for this, but it is still pretty soft, so I don't think I will have any issues. Like this. And then it's very easy because the yellow one is going on the yellow tap. Oh, that's very nice. I love when stuff is color-coded like this. That is just so nice. Voila! And then this one on. And then to see if it actually made any difference. That is going to be exciting. Oh yes. We don't have a lot of fuel left, so even though I have only driven 200 kilometers since last fill up, as far as I know, if I remember correct. So it's a good thing to have this fixed because this is so nice. Woohoo! And next up, I would like to fix that broken cable for the heater valve. I wonder if this was the best way to try to go about that. Because it doesn't really seem to make much room. So I actually took the radio out with two screws, and then there was two more down here. And then I could take the entire panel out because that is going to make it a lot easier. And then it's the cable right there that goes from here and right back to the valve back here. And this is going to be difficult to film. So you're just gonna have to take my word on it that I'm going to fix it. I'll be back in a second. So there we go. The lever is in there. And I have fitted the cable, and take a look what happens when I turn the or pull the knob. Whoop. 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 So yes, this was too small stuff. That is now fixed on the Skoda. And even though it was pretty minor, the fuel gauge is a big thing in my mind, actually, because it's a bit like walking around in a good shoe with a hole in it. It's just so annoying. And I really like when stuff like that is working. And the heater, of course, is also, I actually already got used to just taking my hand and turn the lever all by myself or with my hand when driving, so it wasn't a big deal. But now it actually works. Next up in the cabin is to fix the heater motor because it's not working, and also the wiper motor, but that will be for another day. This will be all in this car for now. I will get back to work on that later. But this car is just so much fun to drive. I took it to the first meet, actually. At last, it's possible to have classic car meets in Denmark again. It's been almost 2 years now since I've been to one last time. So most of the guys laughed off the Skoda, but I was expecting that. It's completely okay. that is just the way of the game in a Skoda. I love it though. Thank you for watching and see you in the next one.